Coming up next, Evangelist Shirley Mars with Stir Up the Gifts. Evangelist Shirley Mars' sponsors are Pastor Kenneth Fly of Inspirational Church in San Antonio, Texas, Mr. Leroy Shields, Mr. Andrew Young, Pastor Howard and Evangelist Myra Hampton of Right Way Missionary Baptist Church in San Antonio, Texas, Mr. William and Miss Jewel Johnson, Miss Dolores Pena Sanchez, and Miss Yvette Mars. And now, Evangelist Shirley Mars comes to you.
Good morning to you in Radio Land. When I think of the goodness of Jesus and all he's done for me, my soul cries out, hallelujah, thank God for saving me. It's so good to be in the land of the living. We also are in the land of the dying. People are dying every day. Every day a soul is being lost. I come to you today out of the Old Testament, the second epistle of Paul, which is a letter that Paul wrote to a young pastor by the name of Timothy. 2 Timothy, 1 chapter, verses 1 through 6. I'm not going to talk about the gifts of the Spirit right now or stirring up the gifts, but I do want to talk about Paul. He was appealing to Timothy to be faithful. And you know, I think the reason Paul did this is because I read in a commentary and some other books that I studied out of that he was a young man, a young pastor, most likely in his 20s. So Paul didn't want Timothy to get off track by listening to other people or other voices. He wanted Timothy to fulfill what God would have him to do. So Paul wrote Timothy a letter and telling him to be faithful. So now I just want to focus on verse 6. Stir up the gift in that verse. But first of all, I want to say a few words about Paul. He was Saul before he was Paul. Saul in the beginning of his life. He knew God. But somewhere along the way, he got off track. Saul tells me he was a religious person. So, and also he was a Pharisee. He was a man of the Jewish sect. He was a righteous person. He was a hypocrite. And sometimes when we're changing in Christ, we backslide. So I just want to kind of put in perspective that he backslid. Saul became a mean person. He was chasing after Jesus' followers. And followers is a disciple of God. So these people were trying to live and do what God would have them to do. But Satan got busy, and Satan got into Saul. He did not believe that Jesus had risen. We're talking about Saul, from death. He was so sure that he was right about that. Saul hurt and even killed people who believed in Jesus. You know, God wanted Saul to work for him. Jesus wanted Saul to work for him, to spread the good news. But instead, Saul wanted to do his own thing. It's kind of like Jonah. God told Jonah to go to Nineveh. Jonah boarded that ship. He got on that ship, boat, whatever you want to call it, and he was trying to run from Jesus. He didn't want to go and make sure those people were saved to do what God would have him to do. He had a gift, but was he trying to use that gift to edify God? No. He was trying to run from God. But we know the old saying, you can run, but you can't hide. So he did not get away. Jonah did not get away. He was on that boat, but he was tossed off that boat into the whale mouth. Some people say fish, but I said the whale. He was there for 3 days and three nights. He prayed to God. You know, sometimes when we don't do what God wants us to do, or we do something that God didn't want us to do, the first thing we say to God, God, if you do this for me, I won't do that anymore. If you do this for me, I promise you I'll do the right thing. And sometimes God blesses us, give us a second chance to do better. And what we do, sometimes we don't do better. We go back to the same thing. But here, Jonah didn't get away. Jonah did not get away. We can't run from God. We can't get away from God. Whatever God wants us to do, we're going to do it one way or the other. Whatever he wants us to do. And when God speaks to you, tell you what he wants you to do, then you need to do that. Because God will never tell you to do something and not make preparation for you to do whatever he called you to do. So we see here that Saul was on the road to Damascus, riding a horse. But a bright light shined down on him. And Saul fell from the horse, the beast, on the ground. And God talked to him. He asked him, why are you persecuting me? And Saul said, who are you? He said, I'm Jesus. Jesus demanded Saul to get up and go into the city. When Saul stood up, he was blind. See, God can do anything he wants with us. We can see. He can allow us to see. He can allow us to be blind. He can allow us to not hear. He can allow us not to walk. God can do anything he wants to do. Why? Because he created this body. But you know, Saul's friends had to lead him into the city. And God gave, gave them a specific instructions. God sent a man named Ananias to find Saul and pray for him so he could see again. So we see that Ananias prayed for Saul and his sight came back. That's good news. And on that day, his name was changed from Saul to Paul. He was converted. Now he was at a stage where he's converted, he's born again, he has the Holy Spirit, and God can use him to do what he wants him to do in the beginning. So, when we think about stirring up the gift of God, all of us got a gift. You might not realize what your gift is, but we all have a gift. We all have a talent. And we say, well, I don't know what my gift is. You know, what is my gift? How do you not know what my gift is? That's when you talk to God, you meditate, you pray, you fast, and you talk to God and let God talk to you. But give God time to answer you. Just get a little silence in there and give God time to answer you. Because whatever God wants you to do, you're going to do it. You're going to do whatever God wants you to do for Him. And we're to work out our soul salvation for the Lord. So some people say, I can't sing, I can't pray, I can't do this, I can't do that. We have excuses. And I was told excuses is nothing but little lies. But we all have something that we can do for God. But when God gives us a gift, when God gives us a talent, we need to use it and use it for His glory. Now, sometimes we have gifts to sing, we have gifts to preach, but sometimes we want to involve ourselves in money-wise with whatever we're doing. And yes, it takes money to operate and do things. But if you do what God say do, the money will come later. Just be obedient to the will of God. Step out on faith. Hebrews 11 says, now faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. No, you can't see it. But you got to have faith that God would do what He said He would do. And God is not a liar. And nor is He a man that He needs to repent. Whatever He said He's going to do, He's going to do it. So I say to you today, pray to God about your gift. Oh, you might have people say, I can't, oh, she can't sing. She can't do this, she can't do that, he can't do this, he can't do that. Don't worry about people. Do you know we have people that put us down simply because sometimes they can't do what God has given us to do? But I'm reminded of the song, what God has for me, it is for me. And what God has for you, it is for you. So stir up the gift of God. Find out what your gift is and do it. It don't have to be just singing, preaching, praying. Your gift could be helping somebody. Your gift could be using your automobile to take somebody that don't have a car to take care of their business, go to the doctor, go to the grocery store, whatever. It just don't have to be centered just around in the church. Musician, a drummer, a guitar player, or whatever. Whatever your gift is, use it for God. Give God the glory. Give God the praise. Because God will do whatever He needs to do. So in my conclusion, I love God. I thank God for where I'm at. I haven't always been where I'm at now, but I praise God for where I'm at now. I praise God for opening my eyes. I praise God for forgiving me for my sins. I praise God for lifting me up. I praise God to take me to another level. I praise God to just increase my territory. I pray to God because I know that God is able to do exceedingly, abundantly, and above all we ask. So take it to God. God can do all things. All things. Just pray to Him. God will take care of us. Do His will. And if we do His will, He will bless us. In Jesus' name. Amen. Sing along, you reign above every name.
Come on, say with power and majesty.
Power and majesty. Dominion, authority. You reign.
With
power and majesty, dominion, authority, you reign.
Come on, let's go right here. Oh, sing my God reigns.
My God reigns.
Sing our God reigns.
Our God reigns.
Tell Him, Lord, you reign.
Church,
sing it.
Sing, but God came to hear you sing. Open your mouth, say, oh.